The way they welcomed us, that was an amazing thing. I think that was probably one of the most emotional parts for me. Just seeing everybody on the streets and singing and running after the vehicles, crazy.
And then the ceremony, all those kids dancing. The woman that was organizing had to come and stop them because they wouldn't stop dancing for us and just singing.
So right now, if you look outside, you'll see all the people that are waiting for different things. This is where everything starts out right here. People are waiting to be seen, and there's a line of people waiting to be triaged. You'll notice the children are over here. They're a priority for us. So we've got all these children that are gonna be triaged into the clinic. This is reception and triage one and triage two. They take place inside this room. This is where everybody gets their vital information and their basic history taken so the doctors know what to do. When they're done with them, they bring them out here. This is the line of people that's already being triaged. They're waiting to actually see a doctor right now. When they need to see one of the doctors, we have a number of rooms that are set up across here. We actually have 9 doctors on staff right now at this moment, but they are taking care in their own individual rooms at the moment. If a person has to actually see the doctor, they go into the room. When they're finished with the doctor, after getting their consultation, everything else that they need, when they're done with the doctor, they're either sent directly to the pharmacy to get their medication, or they're sent to physical therapy, to nutritional counseling, or to the laboratory. What you can hear behind me is the generator, which is really important because without power, we're not able to take care of the lab. That's the next place I want to take you.
I've been working in triage for the past couple of days, and it's been stressful, but at the same time, very fulfilling. We have been working on taking vitals for adults, kids. The doctors need to have everything ready for them to prescribe the medication that they need.
This is the laboratory. Now, laboratory is right beside the generator. They use the most power, so that's what you can hear behind me. But the laboratory is a very important part of this particular mission because it allows the doctors to be able to properly diagnose the patients. We do a lot of testing, especially for HIV and malaria, hepatitis B, hepatitis C. Those are the biggest tests that we're doing inside in this particular facility. I'm gonna take you now to the pharmacy.
An extreme amount of HIV positive people. What touched me the most was the amount of mothers that have been tested HIV and they have their children. I had a mom that had three of her four children with HIV, and that was just heart-wrenching for me.
This is the pharmacy. Now, there's patients who've already finished everything else that they need to do. They've gone through their labs, they've seen their doctors, and they've gotten their additional consultation. Now they're here, if necessary, to pick up their medication from the pharmacy. Pharmacy gets restocked almost every single day, depending on the cases that we had that particular day, and the doctors and the pharmacy staff try and figure out what needs we're gonna have going forward. So we've had a lot of help from the local community in making sure that our pharmacy is well stocked and able to handle all the different cases that we have coming in. One of the special services that we offer here that's kind of outside the regular medical clinic is dental. Very popular. There are not a lot of dentists in the country as a whole. So the fact that we're offering free dental care is a really big part of the mission trip. Dental takes place right here. Our dentist wishes very much that she had a dental chair, and hopefully on the next mission trip she will.
I got to help the dentist one day and I had so much fun helping one of the little boys. He was crying, he was so scared to get his teeth taken out, and I was able to calm him down and hold his hand. And it's just amazing experiences to be able to give that practical love to someone that you never knew before that moment.
We pray for blessings, we pray for peace. Comfort for family, protection while we sleep.
This is the surgical room. At the moment, just a minor surgery that's taking place here. We're not able to handle extreme cases here, just very minor surgical operations. They take place in this particular space. We were fortunate on this particular trip. There is a hospital about 45 minutes away from here, and we got permission to use their surgical room. They have one tiny little room, which they don't use because they don't have a surgeon. We have five surgeons, and so they have been going over there, and you're gonna see what was able to take place at the surgical facility as well.
What if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? Trials of this life, all your mercies in disguise. We pray for wisdom, your voice to hear, and we cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness, we doubt your love, as if every promise from your word is not enough. And all the while you hear each desperate plea, and long that we'd have faith to believe. What if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes?
We pray and hope that it does come from the heart, and I think that's what touches them, and I think that's the biggest impression that you can leave with them, because you can leave them with clothes and crayons and paper and medicine, but that all runs out. And I don't think love ever does. So I think that's why I'm happy to see them smile, because I think that that's true happiness.
You see hundreds, maybe thousands of people. Everybody needs everything. Everybody needs clothes, medicines. They need doctors. They need everything. But the mission is finished. You go back to our countries, and they don't gonna have doctors. They don't gonna have clothes. They don't gonna have food anymore. But I'm sure they always gonna remember everybody was here. Our love. You give love for them, this is gonna stay forever. Disappointments or the aching of this life is the revealing of a greater thirst this world can't satisfy. And what if trials of this life, the rain, the storms, the hardest nights, all your mercies in disguise.
To see how the children laughed, and some were shy, but eventually when they saw the rest of the children play, they all wanted to join. And it was nice seeing them laugh and play with us.
Come home. come home, 'cause I've been waiting for you for so long, for so long. And right now there's a wall between the vanities, but all I see is you and me. Fight for you is all I've ever known, ever known. So come.
Even in the circumstances that they're in, they always find something to do, you know, and the sack race and volleyball and all this stuff, like, and also learning how to brush their teeth. I thought that was so cool because I was actually helping the dentist, the dental hygienist, and we were cleaning out this dude's teeth, and it was really bad, you know, and he says that he doesn't even brush because it hurts so much, you know. So teaching the kids early how to brush their teeth and like teaching them, you know, all this stuff that we're teaching them right now, how to brush their teeth properly, how to wash their hands, and then how to play with each other. Like, I think that's so important, you know. It's like, I really appreciate the children's team and their work here.
Fiery throngs of muted angels giving love but getting nothing back. Oh, people, help the people.
For me, ultimately, still the biggest thing is what our volunteers are doing. I can't imagine how it is for them to work under these conditions and to give up their summers, give up their vacations, pay their own way to get here, and then have me yelling and screaming at them all day long saying, go to work, triage board, go faster, and still be willing to get up and do it again the next day and the next day and the next, the whole time that we're here. The hours are amazingly long. You have to get up early in the morning, working under unbelievable conditions. For me, still the most amazing part is the team that assembles here.